हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल स्टडी ऑफ लाइफ साइंस। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट फोटोपीरियोडिज्म। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। फोटोपीरियोडिज्म, फोटो मींस लाइट एंड पीरियड मींस लेंथ ऑफ टाइम। सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फोटोपीरियोडिज्म? फोटोपीरियोडिज्म इज नथिंग बट द रिएक्शन ऑफ प्लांट एंड एनिमल्स to the length of day and night. It is called as a photoperiodism. It means the plant which induce their flowering by the response of the length of day and night duration. It is called as a photoperiodism. The plant consists of special type of photoreceptor proteins called as a phytochrome. So we can say here this phytochrome, which are active form PFR, these proteins are responsible for the induce the flowering of plant. These proteins which sense the length of day and night, and that lead to the induce of flowering of short day plant and long day plant. Okay, so how we can say that a particular plant which induce their flowering or those plant are short day plant or those particular plant are the long day plants? So for that this present a critical length duration. So we can see here this is a critical day duration. So this black line, it is called as a critical length. If the plant which induce their flowering above this critical level, so we can say that this is a long day plant. If the plant which induce their flowering below this critical level, so we can say that this is a short day plant. So according to the induce the flowering of plant, they divides into the five main categories. So let's start. The first, which is a long day plant. Second, which is a short day plant. Third one, which is a day neutral plant. Fourth one, which is a short long day plant. And last, fifth one, which is a long short day plants. Okay, so we discuss step by step. The first, which is a long day plant, the name suggests that the long day plant, it means the plant which requires the light above the critical levels. It means they require the light 40 to 60 hours for to induce their flowering. This long day plant, they also called as a short night plant because they require the short dark duration as compared to the light. So if you comparison here the critical length, this long day plant which requires the light above the critical levels, usually 40 to 60 hours requires light to induce the flowering of this long day plant. So we can see in that long day plant which induce the flowering when the light duration is above the critical level. And this long day plant which not found where the day duration is too short, obviously for the induce their flowering which requires the long duration. So ultimately they not found where the light duration is too short. Okay, the example is spinach and radish. Next is short day plant. So name suggests that the short day, it means the plant which requires induce their flowering which requires short day. Usually they requires 8 to 10 hours for induce their flowering. So we can say here the plant which requires in a short day plant, they requires a day which is below this critical level. So we can see there this is a short day plant. So here the plant which induce their flowering when the day length is very short. Okay, and this short day plant, they also called as a long night plant. In a short day plant, if you interrupt here the night duration or in dark duration of that light, in that condition this plant which not induce their flowering. But in the case of long day plant, if you interrupt here the dark period, still they induce their flowering. But as compared to this short day plant, if you interrupt this dark portion, this short day plant which not induce their flowering. And same here, long day plant, this short day plant which not found where the day length is too high. Okay, it means which larger the day duration. Okay, it means it is usually 40 to 60 hours day duration or the light which is not required for to induce the flowering of short day plants. So ultimately those plants which not found that particular region. The example is soybean and tobacco. Okay, the third one which is a day neutral plant. The name suggests that it's a neutral. It means those plants which not interrupt or those plants which not plant which induce their flowering which not requires any kind of short day, long day duration. This plant which produce their flowering in any day or long duration. Okay, it means here we can say that this plant which induce their flowering above the critical levels or the plant which induce their flowering below the critical level. It means those plant which not any impact of change length and light duration. That is called as a day neutral plant. Okay, the example is tomato and peas. Fourth one which is a short long day plant. Usually these are a long day plant, but at the initial life they requires a short day. So in that this plant initially they require the short, but usually they are a long day plant. The example is triticum vulgare. Okay, so in that the first which is required a short day, next later they requires a long day. Okay, triticum vulgare. Last one is the long short day plants. So here these plants are usually the short day plants, but the initially life they requires a long day and then which requires a short day. The example is bryophyllum. So in that both condition initially of the plant life they requires a different day length and later on they require a different day length in both the condition. Here which requires a short day and here it requires a long day at initially, and here is a long day and here is a short day. Okay, so this is all about the five types of photoperiodism. Okay, so now let's move there some little bit about how the changes take place of the phytochrome enzyme. Okay, photoreceptor proteins. So I told you that this PFR, so we can see this is a PFR. This PFR are active form of these proteins, and PR are inactive form of proteins. So during light what happens, we can see they absorb the red light. This PR which absorb the red light and this PR are converted into the PFR R. This is active form and this is inactive form. Okay, so in that daytime, what happened, this PR which absorb the red light and all this PR which converted into the PFR are the active form of proteins. And this active form of proteins which lead to induce the flowering of long day plant. It is very important when during daytime what happens, this PR which are inactive, they absorb the red light and this PR which all converted into the PFR which are active form of these proteins, and that lead to induce the flowering of long day plant. Okay, and during night time, okay, so during night time what happened, and in that long day plant I told you that the light duration is longer as compared to the night. So this PFR in that night, this PFR are converted into the PR. But due to the shortage of night prey, this PFR R which not totally converted into the PR, and the large amount of PFR which are active form that lead to formation of or into the flowering during long day plant. Okay, so let's see about the short day plants. So what happened in the short day plant? So in the short day plant, I told you that the day length is shorter as compared to the dark or night. So what happened? This PFR at a time of night, and you know the night in short day plant are longer as compared to day. So this PFR are totally converted into the PR, which are inactive form of this protein, and this less amount of PR less amount of PFR which leads to into the flowering of short day plant. It means the less amount of PFR which induce the flowering of short day plant, and the large amount of PFR which induce the flowering of long day plant. It is very important and should be understood. So I hope you understand how it's the flowering is produced long day, short day plant, and day neutral, there is not any matter the induce the flowering in any condition. Okay, so this is all about the photoperiodism. So if you like these videos, please like, share with your friends, and definitely subscribe my channel. Thank you.